I didn't mean it. It was the alcohol in me. But here's a true story about a cousin of mine. He went to see a friend at school. He brought a girl in a wine. His friend not being in, Joe drank it up all alone. And stumbling past the music room, he saw a double-decker xylophone. Now he lifted it out the window, past the guardhouse on the Staten Island Ferry, the bus, the train, and then home. But early the next morning, he gets a call on the telephone. It appears he'd been spotted riding the xylophone down a hill. And if he don't up and return it, they're gonna throw him right in a cell. Now he's singing, "Judge, I'm not guilty. Judge, set me free. Judge, I didn't mean it. It was the alcohol in me." Well, right after Joe gets a phone call, I get a phone call from Joe. Says, "Hey, Muffin, how you doing?" I says, "I'm doing fine, Joe. What's new with you?" He says, "Nothing much. Wanna buy a xylophone?" I said, "Joe, where did you get a xylophone?" He says, "I borrowed it from a friend." I said, "You got a xylophone you borrowed from a friend, and you trying to sell it to me?" I found it. I said, "Joe, what does a xylophone look like?" He says, "It's a double-decker xylophone, beautiful oak hand-carved wood. It's just like the one Lionel Hampton used to play, only better." I said, "Joe, let me get this straight. You got a xylophone better than the one Lionel Hampton played, made of hand-carved wood, double-decker, that you found or borrowed from a friend, and you're trying to sell it to me? How much?" "Well, because we're cousins, I'll let you have it for $150. But I suggest that you act fast, because a lot of people want this thing." I said, "Yeah, Joe, they want it back." "Well, Joe, I'm gonna ask you one more time where you got the xylophone better than the one Lionel Hampton played, made of hand-carved oak double-decker, that you say you found or borrowed from a friend, that you're trying to sell to me for $150? I'll take $80. I made Joe ride that xylophone on the bus, the train, the Staten Island Ferry, past the guardhouse and back to school. And he walked into the dean's office, said, 'Here's your xylophone, be cool.' But he said, 'No, no, not so fast. We're pressing charges, my friend.' But Joe had other plans, so he rode it right out again. But he rode that xylophone to the Staten Island PD. And he walked in telling his story, expecting a little sympathy. But after they all stopped laughing and caught their breath, the captain walked over and said, 'Boy, you're under arrest.' No, no. I'm not guilty. Judge, set me free. Judge, I didn't mean it. It was the alcohol in me." Well, Joe spent the night in the tombs. That's a place you go in New York when you kill people, with some of the meanest dudes he ever saw. And the ugliest, the toughest, most evil man in the whole place walked over to Joe and looked him in the eyes and said, "Hey boy, what are you in here for?" Well, Joe kind of looked up and smiled and said, "Grand larceny got me in. But when he mentioned he stole the xylophone, he pissed on him. Well, Joe was released the very next day in the custody of his mother. And with the help of a crooked lawyer and a wino judge, he was found not guilty of all the charges. But Joe, as I sit here tonight, looking back on that fateful day, there's just one question that's been in my mind all these years that I just gotta know. Joe, why'd you do it? Why'd you do it? You didn't rob a baby grand piano. Oh, oh, oh.